So after my disastrous coffee spill, I've had to clean up. We're now ready to make the top row, and these are going to be slightly different to the other three rows in that they're only going to be 2 inches tall and there's no divider between. So again, we have the 5.5 inch hinges only mitered at the one end, so at the back end. The base, they're all the sides and bottom, top and bottom, are cut at 5.5 inches long. The top and bottom is cut at 2 7/8 inches wide, so it's not going to be as wide as the, that's a bit long, that one, it's not going to be as wide as the other layers, but there's going to be 4 of them. I'll work with that. So again, all the measurements will be in a document linked below in the description. So we've got, so we need 8 of the 5.5 inch hinges and 4 each of the 2 7/8 and the 2 inches. Okay, because again the height is only 2 inches in the top layer. Goodness me, it's a hinge, for goodness sake. Oh, you're kidding me. Now, this is the top piece here. Probably just did that wrong, so let's put that aside. Really matter. Okay, and then this is the top. Okay, so now we can attach the sides there, then the top. Okay, so we need one for this. To join the side, the other side to the top. Okay. Again, we're only kissing the edges of each of those pieces. This is the awkward bit, trying to get these connected. Okay. that over and we can press them down. Okay, that's that. Now the remainder of the hinges just reinforces it. So again, we're going to be using the wet glue. And over hanging these hinges slightly. Okay, and I'm just using Scotch Quick Dry on this. It's not as thick as the Aileen's tacky. Around we go. We need to make four of these all up, and let's hope they fit together the same width as the other sections. Okay, I'll be back.
Thank you.